join me here at the lectern and raise your right hand. I swear that I will carry out. I swear that I will carry out the duties of my office.
The duties of my office.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
I will strive.
I will strive
to maintain the ethics of the medical profession.
To maintain the ethics of the medical profession.
And to promote the public's health and welfare.
And to promote the public's health and welfare.
I will dedicate myself and my office.
I will dedicate myself and my office
to the task of bringing increasingly improved medical care.
To the task of bringing increasingly improved medical care
to the people of Hawaii.
To the people of Hawaii.
I will uphold the Constitution and bylaws.
I will uphold the Constitution and bylaws
of the Hawaii Medical Association at all times.
Of the Hawaii Medical Association at all times.
Ladies and gentlemen, your president.
A big round of applause for a bunch of great volunteers up here, the past presidents of the Medical Association, the countless hours that they have put in over the years. And how about a nice big round of applause for these public servants. Delivering some rather concerning news, but there's some solutions here, and we just got to reach down as an island, as people, all stakeholders in the healthcare equation to solve this problem and many others. But first, I've got some thank yous to make. Of course, mahalo to Dr. Kelly Withy for introducing this film and all the work she's doing. Thank you to my wonderful wife, Deborah, down here for contributing to my volunteerism and putting up with it. And countless other things as well, darling. Thanks to my fabulous daughter and nurse who's here tonight, Libby McCaffrey, right over here, wave please, for supporting him here. And also a big mahalo to my big sister, Claudia Johnson, and her husband, Chuck, who came from Colorado to support me tonight, right over here. Thanks to Dr. Andrew Durman, and president of AMA, as well as AMA Political Action Committee Chair Dr. Robert Puchalski, who is out there somewhere. He is the head of the American Medical Association Political Action Committee, and we know how political medicine has been become in the last decade. So thanks to those guys for taking the time to swear me in and to bring their national level of expertise to the islands here. Mahalo to Dr. Kalani Brady. Where are you, Kalani? Out there for that great job of channeling all that aloha. Dr. Robert Marvin, Dr. Jazz, the past president, for the great jazz performance out in the foyer there during cocktail hour, and the contribution they make, not just to medical talent, but to pure raw talent as well in the performing arts. Thanks to Dr. Flanders, Jessica, Yvonne, for your continued hard work. Where are you guys? For really holding down the fort at the Hawaii Medical Association headquarters, the planning and execution of this wonderful event. Can we have a round of applause for those guys? And the commitment for the gracious talent, as well as her commitment to helping retain local grown doctors. And she hasn't talked about this too much, but she's a woman on a mission trying to retain doctors in Micronesia that are coming here homegrown and keep them here. And that's one of the big themes of my presidency, is we gotta have to fix this doctor shortage problem and keep every Jamson graduate here on the islands, as well as be more successful in recruiting new doctors to serve the public. And of course, thanks to Christian Lay for, boy, what a voice she has. I saw her at an event out at Queens West, and we were out in a tent on the lawn, and she just blew the roof of the tent right off. And I knew she had a dynamic voice, and she came in here, she blew the roof off of this joint. So, wow. And she's coming back long too. She'll come back to do at least one more number. And of course, many mahalos to our sponsors that are making this all possible. So, to all my physician colleagues here tonight and their dedicated staff who work tirelessly, night and day, to deliver some of the best medical care on the planet, to the great doctors and leaders of John Burns School of Medicine for passing the torch of knowledge to the next generation of doctors, to our colleagues in the legal profession, some of whom are here tonight for making sure, where are you at the mat at table? Where are you guys? Put your hand up. Thank you. For making sure, as advocates for our patients and their clients, a doctor's order and treatment plan is still a doctor's order. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. So all of those who volunteer in the care of indigent and the misfortunate and the underserved, especially our esteemed colleagues and members of the Philippine Medical Association of Hawaii, currently led by President Carolina Davide. Dr. Davide, where are you? You have set a high bar in our islands and globally for the delivery of selfless care to humanity, and who inspire me in my own volunteerism continually. And in addition to that, these folks know how to dance, party, and celebrate life. So a big round of applause for the Philippine Medical Association. To Dr. Thomas Kosasa, for whose generosity is always beyond words, Tom. Donna Kim, all right over here. The legislators who, by the way, serve as doctors do, as public servants, when they're doing their job right. And she has so many years of great service. And finally, to all the medical students, where's the medical student table? Right there, right there. To all the medical students and residents here tonight, all working members of Hawaii Medical Association, in whose caring hands lies the future of healthcare. I say this, ladies and gentlemen, esteemed colleagues, I stand before you a walking, talking, medical miracle and living demonstration of the power of medical technology delivered by caring hearts and hands. I have been vaccinated, repaired, fused, stented, and ablated, and because of such interventions, and by the way, my neurosurgeon who fused my back is here tonight. Dr. John Graham, would you please, I want to personally talk to you. Where are you? God bless you, man. And all of these fabulous interventions that have allowed me at age 65 to stand here before you and still able to run, bike, swim, ski, climb, and ski like the wind. I also stand before you tonight, a humble man, before this historic position I've been elected to. Now, the challenges before us and our wonderful profession are many and profound. But rather than bore you with a dry analytic assessment of all these issues, I literally took some poetic license as HMA's new president and wrote this piece, which hopefully captures the spirit of some of the unique healthcare issues of our times. It's entitled, What If? In 1856, it all began a covenant with the government. Cape Kamehameha IV and some doctors founded the Hawaii Medical Association. You know, I went to school every day thinking that there would be a day when you could help make people better, become a man of letters, believe in some pain, relieve some pain, and maybe even cure. To your Hippocratic oath, be pure, make a contribution to the world. But nobody told us that to get to be a physician, you had to be some kind of financial magician. $200,000 medical student loans in the hole, and houses in Hawaii, 750,000 or more. Now, we can put others in white coats with less training to ease our minds, but it is the caring and the disciplined clinical mind you need when the seconds counts and everything is on the line. Yes, it's the caring, not just the repairing, that brings it to the house versus the current regulatory games of cat and mouse. Cost control, we get it, but when you or your loved ones are on the line, you will do anything, never mind all the dimes, in a world of limited resources with our Hippocratic oath on the line. That's the covenant that binds us, the North Star that guides us, bringing our best game to work every day to put the patient first all of the time. Death with dignity, a historic reality, always keeping the patient and family in the decision center, which has always been part of the medical art. With the miraculous technologies, we yield our power with humility, never taken for granted the trust, so uphold it we must. Control freaks, guilty as charged. Because in your time of disorder, confidence is in order to calm the fear, the dis-ease in it. We must be in charge and accountable too. Patient-centered medical home paid for performance. Sometimes it makes us feel all alone. All good intention, but not new inventions in what we do and the historic norm of good doctors everywhere. Digital records, a beautiful dream, informatic sharing for the medical team. But please don't slow us up because there ain't enough of us. ICD-10, really bringing us down, keeping up with the coding world, trying to comply, but some good doctors and hospitals might drown, and there's not enough of us. You know, there's plenty of money running through our healthcare system's hands to provide the very best care for our fellow man by looking through the lens of each other's eyes, keeping our hearts and our minds on the ultimate prize of an island home where we can offer the best to the homeless, the rich man, the neighbor, the rest. With a chosen path of mutual cooperation, we can show the rest of the nation that the Prepaid Health Care Act of 64, women's health care rights, and many other Hawaiian innovations were not accidents, but just the beginning. And because of our uniqueness here, in Hawaii, we have been able to do these great things and can do so much more. So, here's the prescription I'm pitching. In this canoe called Hawaii, we must paddle forward, providers, employers, the payers, the oarsmen, with challenging waves all around us that could swamp this boat. Yes, let's come together as one, providers, payers, politicians, and even the chamber, because we're all in this same canoe together with paddle in hand. We can collectively take a stand for efficiency in healthcare delivery. It's the right way to a brighter day of a better tomorrow, where every citizen gets the care that they need in the time that they need it. To help lead the way to this medical future, we're doubling down with Aloha for sure, sir, and HMA stands ready and has across the ages. So thanks, HMA, for the higher grace of helping the doctors all stay in the race. The Hawaii Medical Association is here to do its part, reaching out to the world with its medical heart. 160 years and just getting started today. Because HMA is in it for the long game. Let the hope grow, because with the spirit of Aloha, you know that together we can move mountains. And if not us, then who? And if not now, then when? Thank you very much.